Giggs did drop music today.
Yeah.
Have you listened to the album?
I did listen to the album. You two did not.
No.
Are you going to, though?
What's the highlights?
Wait. Can I get to this straight away?
Probably not.
No, can I get to this straight away? This is what I wanted to speak to you about, Martin, yeah?
All right.
There was... Sorry to cut you as well, Ali. We're going to review it straight after. Mm-hmm. But there is one song I wanted to know what Martin's thoughts was. Because I heard this guy, yeah? Well, I saw the feature and I was like, what am I going to get? And I heard it and I was like, he sounds different. I was like, I'm low-key rocking with it. I'm just going to play a little piece of it. You got the earphones on?
Yeah.
I think the money changed me. Yeah. I see me and you. Hey, Boogie! Same, yeah. Crazy, I'm insane, baby. Same, baby.
Yeah. Okay, baby. Yeah, stop it there. I'm definitely going to be spitting this one. But you don't love me no more. Yeah, I am not a fucking ghost. Yeah, but I put up in a ghost. Yeah, but you don't fuck with me no more, baby. You don't even show me love anymore. Niggas out here picking up the full clip. Me and all my niggas and some bullshit. Corporate player with my daughter. Little man just playing in the ball pitch. Copyright. Of course. But I just wanted to give Triple M a flavor because of that was one thing I saw. He was the only US feature on there.
Yeah,
I heard A Boogie on that and I was like, he sounds different. He doesn't sound as whiny. It just sounds. I liked it.
That's how A Boogie sounds, man.
Nah, he sounded a bit different. His tone was a bit different on here.
What's the last A Boogie album you listened to?
Huh? Album.
Hey, the disrespect.
Wait,
the disrespect. Wait, you know I disrespect A Boogie like
my this. My last favorite A Boogie verse was on the 6ix9ine old album Dummy Boy. Let's go back to Giggs. Anyway,
Giggs, the album.
Yes,
dropped.
It was a surprise as well.
How do you feel about it?
You know what? I haven't really enjoyed a full Giggs album in a long time, but he has joints on there for me, and like it wasn't bad. But there was only enough. Again, I do love Giggs. Giggs is a legend.
Yeah.
But the content wise is only going to go so far.
Mm-hmm.
Production wise was okay. But yeah, I got a few standouts on here. Like Debonair. That was one of my. I think that was my favorite track on there because he had Cool and Dre production.
Yes. Floating Nice on there. Really different.
Very nice. And then I liked the next joint on there with Kai's because Kai's just went in and went crazy on there. And then we got that A Boogie joint, Branch Out. Like there was a whole run. And a song that I found fun, No Backbone.
Yeah.
Tiny Boost, I've always respected him. He's Giggs' brother, I think.
Is it?
Actual brother.
Okay.
He's hard. All like they done mixtapes together back in like 2010, 06, like time ago.
Yeah, yeah.
Always been hard. He just came out of prison, I think, last year. Mm-hmm. So I let him on there. And then A-Star on there with the Scouse accent. Can I play you just the accent? Let me just play you the accent. Let me just play you. Because when I heard this guy come on, I was just like, what? And I just started skinning low key.
I think this is one of the first times I've heard a Scouse rap.
This is trash, no disrespect.
You're not ready for the Scousers.
Martin ain't even listening. Martin just shut down. Martin's waiting.
Martin does not want to hear a Scouser rap.
You don't rate UK music, do you?
He doesn't.
I do.
No, you don't.
I like drill. Fuck with drill.
Let's go back to game.
But...
Yeah. Wait, do you know which other feature shocked me? DeMarco. DeMarco classic, reggae, dancehall slash artist.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Shouts out to him. Song with Georgia was dope.
Yeah.
And yeah, there were some alright songs in it, but nothing that really stuck with me after. Even the song with Dave. You want to speak about this? Cause
I'll speak about it.
It wasn't that good, I'm not gonna lie.
How's your day been, Martin?
Fam? I'm trying good. To get through it.
Great.
Yeah. We've got content on the recording.
No, that song with Dave. Disappointing after I've listened to like Peligro off his Wump to Them.
Yes.
And that was a disappointing
feature. It was just this time, man. Mid.
The thing is, I'll actually listen to this because I actually rate Giggs.
But he's got a song with Dave. Not special.
Really?
No one tell me Dave's the best rapper in the UK.
Now, going back to this album, the only two songs that really stood out to me were the one with Georgia and that Debonair.
Yes.
The product. It was the only time the production actually changed up.
Yes.
And that's what I really
exactly.
Because it sounded like it was like grander production.
Actually, that song with Emily Sandy at the end, I never thought I would hear Woke Giggs. I never thought I would hear that ever.
Yeah.
And on that song, he was talking about some woke stuff, you know, BLM, all that type of good stuff. I was like, good on you get. Emily Sunday didn't sound bad on there too.